receivers both left and right.
Let's see a little Williams action.
They have it up on that one.
Justin Hirschfeld, left to Robert Traver, and we're off.
It's like they're unstoppable. It's all about possession defense. They've got to just force a turnover.
Yes, there are a couple of minutes to get back in form when she comes back.
I don't quite get the Bellingham hitting philosophy right now.
Outside to Kristen. And Millis keeps it alive.
Welcome to Medfield Warrior Big Blue Basketball, where the Medfield Warriors are about to face off against the Millis Mohawks. Hi, I'm Rich Small, along with Jerry Potts and Eric Gazelle. So Medfield comes in with a record of 7-4, 7-2 in the CBL, and we think Millis is 5-4, give or take one or two games.
Yeah, it's amazing how little stats are. You know, this whole interweb thing, you'd figure we could get detailed information. But one thing for sure, that when you look at the season for the Warriors, a lot of potential. They take a team like Holliston that's now leading in the Tri-Valley. They beat them. They beat Westwood, and then they unfortunately fall to a team that's 2-7, Ashland. So hopefully we get the good Warriors tonight, and that's a nice way to start.
Oh, right off the bat, Stephen Roy gets the opening tap off and goes in with an uncontested layup. So a little different lineup change from the last time we saw the Warriors.
Yeah, you're used to seeing McGorry in there, and I don't know if it's injury or contract negotiation problems, but
there's up there. To the shot that's off by Merrill Cushman, to the rebound by Dubs. Oh, there's a long three-pointer, and that's just off by the Ranger. Loose ball picked up by Miller.
Oh, nice defense.
And Dubs tried to keep it in. Off to the corner, just going to take a long-range shot. That's back rim. The rebound by Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald brings it up over the timeline. Over to Williams, weaving to Dubs. Michelle's got the dribble stop. Dubs on the drive, back to Lowell.
Oh, yeah, nice really shot. Nice play there. Nice drive there.
Good, nice ball movement there too. Okay, PJ Adams brings the ball down for Millis. Out to Lekozak. Cushman inside pass. That's back rim. Forrest just couldn't get it to go. That was a nice pass from Cushman. Fitzgerald out in the wing. Dubs moves it to Lowell. Dubs keeps it alive.
Wow.
Oh, and a nice power move inside. Metfield up to a quick 6-0 run.
Well, I like it. Good passing, good ball movement, and
strong
so far
inside.
Mills
cold. Like a long outside shot. That's off. With a rebound by Barras,
and he stepped
on the
bounds.
Wow. Steps out on the baseline. Tough start from Millis.
Yeah, they're over so far.
Yeah, we're only 2 minutes into this game. They're already down by six.
Oh, wow.
Ball gets thrown away. And then, oh, geez.
That is just.
There's a drive in out. There's a move. Back rims off. By Zoffinrelli, rebound Fitzgerald, looking to press, goes all the way up and in, and just a little too strong. Oh, nice rebound by Lowell, gets swatted away by the interior of the Millis defense. Nice move by Williams!
Oh, wow.
Beautiful move. Medfield, 8-0, tried the fast break, throws the ball away. Warrior ball, there's going to be a quick substitution by the Mohawks. Boy, they're getting wiped out here. 2.5 minutes gone in the game. They're staring at a double-digit deficit already.
Yeah, although they're not seeming to know how to break a press, which is a little disturbing.
Yeah, Dubs is saying, hey, can somebody come to the ball, please?
Yeah, this is not something that you shouldn't, at this point in the season, be pretty comfortable with.
It's pretty simple stuff. All right, Williams got to inbound it. Over to Fitzgerald. Williams moves to the inside.
That's a beautiful play there. Oh, too bad.
This is a little 8-footer, but you're right. Absolutely a nice step-in move. There's a long-range shot. That's
Whoa. Nothing.
Pilot ties back. Medfield on the run. And Fitzgerald's going to pick up the foul. And that's going against number 11, PJ Adams. You think the scoreboard operator is going to give us the fouls tonight?
Yeah, I don't think so.
Nope. Okay, Fitzgerald, front room to first. Probably cost another $20 or so. She go down and give him $20 just to
really?
Give us the fouls.
Really?
Second free throw attempt. Ooh, just rims out. Rebound Adam. Ball gets thrown away. Williams on a drive, gets caught upside. It's a jump ball.
Wow, that was a quick call, though. I mean, I don't think either one had possession long enough, but.
Well, I think Coach Gray's trying to call a timeout, but they never had possession. It's kind of hard. There's always a loud noise coming from the bench. It's hard to figure out what he's talking about.
Yeah, that's true.
Matezek over to Burris. Burris nowhere to go. Oh, nice. That's a nice inside pass. And Burris finally gets on the scoreboard. Nice pass by Matezek. So Millis finally breaks a 3.5 minute stretch. That was number 13, Carter Burris. Williams with the ball.
Oh, nice feed.
Inside of Pescaro.
Great finish.
Banks it in.
Yeah, nice job there.
Oh, hard inside pass from Brooks. Can't handle by the Mohawk. On the fly.
Oh, nice job by Long.
And there's a timeout by the Mohawk. And Memphis, really impressive first 4 minutes of this game, up 12-2.
Well, they're doing a lot of right. They're playing aggressive on defense. You know, Millis obviously coming out missing 0 for, you know, everything so far. Just quickly looking at it, there Millis 1 for 7, 0 for 3 from 3-point, and the Warriors on a 6 for 10 start, 6 for 9 from 2-point. They're moving the ball well, assists. They're driving and dishing, and. And really, everyone's contributing, so well, nice job.
If the lineup changed with a wake-up call, it's sure working so far.
I'm gonna check with our inside sources.
See what's going on.
So question, Dory.
All right, Jerry's what's trying the, to figure out the, if there was a lineup change or not.
Hey, Len, you know Dory?
Andre?
Okay.
We heard from reliable sources. A Russian hacker has told us that McGorry with a shoulder injury. So.
All right, we checked with WikiLeaks.
WikiLeaks
and McGorry does have an injury today. All right, we'll buy that. It's as good as any story. And we're sticking to it.
I'm sticking to it.
All right, Hillary with it. All the way up and in is Burris. That's off. That's a strong rebound by Lowell. Stubbs crosses over the timeline, goes left, goes right. Oh, just misses. Number 44, Kevin Pine in the game.
That's a tough one.
That's going to be a three-shot foul going against Stephen Williams. So 44 for Millis, they have him listed only in the ninth grade.
Yeah, that's a big
one,
kid.
That's one big dude.
That is a big kid.
Wow, imagine when he starts growing.
Yeah.
All right, Brooks at the line, makes the cross. All right, Brooks is second, he's good. And he's gonna get a third. Looks like they followed the wrong guy so far from the first two free throws. Looks like he has a nice, clean free throw approach.
You jinxed them. Well done.
All right, 12-4, 3:18 left to go in the first.
You have earned your key, my friend. Yes.
Come to the territory. All right, Doug with it. Go real low. There's that inside move. Back to Doug, thinking about it. Ball gets it stripped away. And there's Brooks. It's a nice finish by Brooks. There's that four quick points.
A little bit of a lazy offensive series there, you know. They
got a little cut in between. Fitzgerald looking for it.
Not a lot of movement. Now, this is a mismatch. 5-on-44. Holy cow. There you go.
The Ranger with a three. Okay, Brooks with it. Back to Hillary. Brooks trying to drive. Had a step on the Ranger, but lost the dribble. Pine with it. Back to Zaffirelli. Inside move. Oh, they called it on Williams. I think that's going to be a second. Yeah, it's definitely a second.
Yep.
Coming to the game, it's going to be Marie. Kind of got caught there a little. Zaffirelli with the first. He misses. Okay, Mike Marie in the game. Williams will sit down with the two fouls. Two misses, oh. Yeah, and there's a walk, ooh. Look at that, Fitzgerald came in really hot on Boris.
I thought they might go for the foul call there, but.
All right, 15-6 to 11 left to go in the first.
Mitchell in the game.
Okay, Marie with it. Yeah, Henry Mitchell back in the
gotta
game.
Gotta get across. There you go.
Get throw it down. Oh.
That was a nice pass. Oh. You see the way Mitchell tapped that, just the way they drew it up.
And the Ranger nails the three. Oh, the ball almost went out of bounds.
Boy, I know.
Sloppy play by Millis. They're fortunate.
I've seen them practice that, you know.
All right, Burris with it. He's thinking about it. Top of the key. Oh, Pine with a big rebound, but it slapped it up there. Deep ball. Oh, picked up. Nice play by Doug.
Nice
beautiful feed to the Ranger.
Wow.
And the Warriors extend their lead by 14. Really playing inspired. Maybe that loss the other night gave them
Millis
a little purpose.
Can't find the basket.
No.
I mean it.
Oh, Burris in the mall.
Yeah,
wow.
You can't do that.
And Doug is going to get caught for the foul. Nice baseline drive.
And that foul was on Fitzgerald.
Was it Fitzgerald?
Yeah.
Or Dub?
We'll check it at halftime.
Dubs was complaining like he got called for it. All right, Burris completes a three-point play. Mitchell back to Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald, a nice job weaving through all the traffic. Dubs with the three. That's off. Hillary, quick hands by Hillary. Finally gains control. The Zaffirelli's going to take the three. Oh, he nails it. We saw a little loose in the last game we did against Overshurber.
Yeah.
That failed big lead, and Diaz kind of clawed their way back into it.
Well, again, I mean, they're 4-for-13, so it doesn't take a lot of balls to fall for them to actually have a slightly different.
Nice.
What a nice play.
Nice give and go.
Give and go. That just gets you. It gets you choked up. That's old-fashioned.
It's good fundamental basketball.
Good old give and go. Pick and roll.
That's right.
You're getting verklempt here.
Hillary outside looking to swing it. Hillary with it. He's going to try the three. That's back rim. Rebound
nice
Fitzgerald. 12 seconds left to go in the first. They can hold for one. Fitzgerald just swings it up there. That's Pine with a rebound. And that's going to be the end of the first quarter. All right. Good, solid first quarter for the Warriors.
Yeah, so what's it like there? They were 10 for 17 from the field.
That's
8
a great
for 12.
Shooting first
quarter. Absolutely. 2 for 5 from the three-point. Really, the Ranger reining them in there. Let's quickly look at the team stats. And let's see, we got Dubs with 2 points, Stephen Williams with 4 points, Fitzgerald with 2, Steve LaRanger with 8, John Lowell with 4, Henry Mitchell with 2. So Got a few people in the scoring column there.
What's their three-point shooting accuracy so far?
They are shooting 2 for 5.
Okay.
And LaRanger 2 for 3 from three, so he's leading the charge there. Dubs and Fitzgerald each with a miss at three-point range. Field goal percentage, John Lowell is shooting 2 for 3. LaRanger 3 for 4. Fitzgerald 1 for 3. Stephen Williams 2 for 3. Dubs 1 for 3.
I mean, 10 for 17 is outstanding.
Yep.
Okay. Well, I'm sure Coach Grace would take a similar period in the second as he did the first. Well, they play with a lot of spirit in that first quarter.
Yeah, a nice job, and they will start with the ball.
And the same lineup as they ended the first. Okay, Marie inbounds it to Fitzgerald. And we stop the second. LaRanger outside. Looks like Millis is in a man defense now. Ball gets thrown away, almost stolen, did get stolen. Here's the three-pointer, front rim off. That was by PJ Avo, stolen, and Adams has come back. Now Millis in a three-quarter press. Oh, the ball gets almost stolen away. Dug with it.
Oh, and he's nice
up that end. The problem with the Millis press, they didn't try to trap anybody. You're not gonna get it if you don't trap. Ooh, almost a walk by Hopkins.
Yeah.
Back to Adams. Long with it, and that gets thrown away.
I like that.
It's a bad turnover. All right, midfield ball. Three with the most inside pass to Mitchell.
Nice job.
Well, that's going against Pine. All right, Mitchell's going to go to the line for 2. Hey, makes the first. Okay, 6:46 left to go in the half. Medfield up by 11. Mitchell with second free throw. Nice form.
Nice job. Yeah, really. Good, I was gonna say, good lead, man.
Okay, a little trap. Hopkins gets hit. Adams with it. Going to roll over to Wong. That's way off. Play the rebound by Hopkins. Deep ball. Who wants it? It's going to be a jump ball. It's going to be Millis' ball. So Medfield sits in that 2-3 zone. It's kind of there. That's most of what they do for most of the game. Well, yeah. Wow. That's a big alley-oop.
Yeah, that's a Henry Mitchell alley-oop. You know, that's an alley-oop you're throwing to a 6'6", 6'7".
Hopkins missed time to Wong. But Millis stays in their man defense. Marie looking for drive. LaRanger's going to take the 3. Oh, and he nails it.
On fire from 3 for 4 from the three-point range.
Wong back to Adams.
Oh, ooh, travel.
Adams almost walked. Wong's going to take it in. Oh, and the half shot, half pass.
Yeah,
Pine.
Do I give that as a miss or do I?
I think
pass?
That was a shot.
Yeah, I'm going to, yes.
Okay, Fitzgerald with it. Mitchell's looking to drive against Pine. Ball gets tipped. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Fitzgerald quickly brings it into the half court.
Brilliant.
Rebound
nice
by Mitchell.
Mitchell.
It's Fitzgerald 3.
Yeah.
Wow.
Big rebound by Mitchell and keeps it alive. Fitzgerald buries him three.
Yeah, Warriors stretch the lead to 16.
Oh, my.
With a turnaround, that's not going anywhere by Daniel. Dubs it. Nice inside pass.
Oh, nice speed.
And that's going against Kurt Hopkins. He's complaining. I'm not sure why. Looked like a pretty good foul there.
Yeah, I think that could have. I think the only thing he's
thought he got ball in there. But his body, pressed.
Someone got him.
All right, Mitchell misses the first. So far, Warriors having most of the way against the Mohawks.
Well, they're doing a lot right.
All right, 1-for-2 for Mitchell. Stretches the lead to 17. Letezek with it over to Adams. Back to Letezek. That's off back rim. Three by LaRanja. Oh, and he just throws it to the midfield bench. Okay, inbounds it to Barras. Okay, Adams has it. Okay, Letezek's going to take it. That's off. Boy, his shooting percentage is dismal.
Yeah, they are 6-for-22.
Wow.
His speed. Great ball movement.
The Ranger thought about it, but all alone is done for two. And it's back there. Nice rebound by Mitchell. A little too strong.
Wow.
And finally, Adams gets the rebound. And Mitchell does a good job of getting back in the defensive position.
Yeah, that's really great hustle. Yeah, nice job there.
All right, Mitchell's going to take a breather, and back into the game comes Lowell.
Wow.
Oh, that pass is going to go out of bounds.
Nice.
Redfield with a steal.
Yeah, they're going to call it. Yeah. They're going to call it. Yeah. It's a shame, but it's the right call.
Yeah, he left it as soon as he left his feet. Is that going to be Dub's second?
That is actually his first.
His first?
Yeah, that is his first.
Okay. .344 left to go in the half. I guess he did a substitution without the ref knowing it.
That's
it had to be something like that. Adams with the ball over to Hopkins, back to Adams. Adams drives.
Good ball, nice
gets
defense there.
Hopkins with it. Not really finding any running room. Gets a tough midfield defense right now. But Tezak, nice inside pass.
That's a nice speed, but they cannot buy a basket.
Yeah, Hopkins couldn't get it to go. The Ranger. Oh, if it's Gerald, he's going to take the three. That's back rimmed off. And the ball saved. Rebound. Finally comes to Adams on the break. And Hopkins has had no room.
Yeah, that's just not going to happen.
Oh, Mitchell did a nice job of the defense.
That's
Marie.
Yeah, that's a off. Great shot, though.
Hopkins with it. Pushes it to Adams. Adams inside. Got intimidated by Mitchell. Mitchell with the rebound.
Wow, nice job there.
Marie dribbles out of trouble. Lowe's going to take it.
Oh,
and just misses. Just in and out. Rebound Letezek over to Adams. Adams stop and pop. That's off.
Wow.
Rebound Lowell.
6-for-25.
Yikes. I guess that's why they're losing by 17.
Yeah, that's a... That's not going to win you a lot of games.
Ball gets knocked out from Reese's hand, circles around,
yeah, you know,
finally gets stolen. And it's going to be a jump ball. That's going to be next to that ball.
Yeah, that's great hustle by Marie there.
Surprised the Millis coach didn't call the timeout there. Millis did have possession.
They did have possession.
Okay, Marie's going to inbound.
They just don't have anything right now that can stack up against Mitchell in there.
The call's going against Cushman. They really only have one tall player. Inside move. Mitchell left his feet and kind of lost the dribble there. Adams dribbles out of a little traffic there. Adams going to take it. Back to back rim. Another miss from Millis. Gerald with the rebound. Marie to Mitchell. Mitchell.
Nice job.
He just followed.
I mean, this is
going against four. It's going against Cushman. That's
two on Cushman.
The fifth foul against Millis. First free throw from Mitchell's up and in. Chance to extend the lead to 19. In and out. Stays at 18. 1:24 left to go in the half. Brooks with it back to Hillary. Long shot from the wing, back rim. Brooks tracks it down to Hillary.
Wow.
Boris, that was way off. Nice hustle play by Hillary. They get slapped by Marie. It's going to be Medfield's 15th foul. Fitzgerald in the game. Marie's gonna take a seat. Long three-pointer by Boris. That's off rebound Lowell. Fitzgerald with it.
42 seconds left here.
Mitchell inside to Lowell. The Rangers gonna take the three. That's off Fitzgerald. Nice rebound. Nice.
Beautiful feed.
Nice dish to Lowell. And Medfield has that 20-point lead. Oh, that's going to be
That's tough.
Wow.
That's tough. Is it, are they calling on?
I don't know. Was that on Lowell?
We'll give it to him and we'll settle it in there.
But the one-on-one, and they missed the front end of it. All right, we're counting down 18 seconds left to go.
Oh, you hit the basket. That basket counted.
Oh, it did count. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Okay. My mistake.
No, it's all right. I finally got one right.
I can't tell with the scorekeeper. They got the team fouls backwards.
Yeah, I'm all confused here. Definitely going to have to.
I don't know what's going on here. They keep on switching back and forth. All right, Boris makes the first. Trying to cut into the Warrior lead. 12.9 seconds left to go in the half. Misses the back end. Fitzgerald quickly pushes the ball up. Mitchell. Fitzgerald, 1-3. That's off. 2 seconds left. Rebound, Jordan, that's going to be the end of the first half. With the Warriors in total command of this game, up by 17 points.
Yeah, there's a lot to like there. You know, 14 for 29 shooting, 4 for 12 from three-point range. And we'll go quickly over some stats here.
Leading scorer, LaRanger, 11 on 4-for-6 shooting. And then a lot of balance. Henry Mitchell, a nice first half, 6 points. John Lowell, 6 points. Fitzgerald, 5 points. Williams, 4 points. Jake Dubs, 4 points. So just under 50% shooting, but shoot almost 60% from the 2-point, 4-for-12 and threes.
Okay, cool. All right, so we'll take a quick halftime break. And you are watching Midfield Warrior Basketball on Midfield TV. All right, back for the beginning of the second half. Mellis gets the ball for us. Adams with it, is down by 17 as we start the third. They got a lot of work to do to try to get back into this one. Oh, there's just a chuck up there by Cushman. But Letezak just makes the drive and gets the two. I'll tell you, they do not have many good shooters on their team.
No, it's been painful to watch.
They just really chuck it up there. What are they shooting? Not to complicate you right now. There's a nice move by Williams. He gets the two.
Yeah, he's shooting 24% from the field, so.
The Metfield's double that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And it's a hard game when you're not putting the ball in the basket.
There you go,
nice drive there.
Yep. Now they're trying to double up and trap the press. They're kind of forced to do this now. Try to get back in the game. Dubs with it. No, nice pass to LaRanger. Oh, he just misses it. A good rebound.
Great rebound
by Lowell. Nice pass inside of LaRanger.
Oh, beautiful job.
Nice ball moment there. Letezak with it. Got a little out of control. Metfield with the ball. Dubs coming down with it hard. Over to LaRanger. LaRanger's going to take the three. Front rim. Fight for the rebound. And Boris with it for the Mohawks.
For the Millis coach, I think you have to do something like you said. You really have to change the dynamic because you cannot hit from the field.
All right, Millis trying to tap it to save it in, but LaRanger with a good hand steals the pass and Dubs with it. So far, a quiet game from Dubs. He has 2 fouls, sat out a lot of that first half. Swings it to Fitzgerald inside of Dubs. Dubs swings around. Oh, that's a nice move inside. Gets his own rebound. Oh, boy, couldn't make it to go.
Yeah, it's tough. That's tough. You know, and great hustle by Dubs, though.
Boy, he's tough inside. All right, inbound by Lowell. Dubs with it again inside, working on Adams. Oh, nice dance for Lowell. And he gets fouled.
Wow. Great feed by Dubs there.
And that's going against Brooks, number 2. And Lowell looking for the 3-point play.
A little strong, but
got a little push off there, huh? big push off.
That was a big one.
Brooks with a cross court over to Boris. Gets it to go. I think Metfield will trade baskets now for the rest of the game if they want to. Fitzgerald back to LaRanger, back to Williams. And Cushman with the rebound. Comes with the drive.
Nice job.
Nice defense by Dubs there.
Yeah.
To get in the way and make him change his dribble. Oh, that's a foul.
Yeah.
Going again, Zaccarelli.
Well, they're going nasty now.
Well, they don't chip away at this lead in the third. This game is going to be over early. Oh, nice inside pass. Oh, LaRanger couldn't handle it.
Yeah,
but got lucky.
Went off the 13. They got lucky.
One off of Boris.
Gotta get out of
Yeah, you have to get out of there, absolutely. Fitzgerald with a drive, dish it off to Williams.
You got a little intimidated. Yeah, you got in there.
Yeah, Pine's a big fella. Brooks fight for the rebound. Dubs gets it. Brings it quickly into the front court. Got a little cut up in a dribble there. That's going to be a jump ball. It's going to stay midfield. Okay, got Hopkins in the game for Millis. Fitzgerald with it. Comes all the way over.
Oh, wow.
That was a little weird. Hopkins, oh, nice. Yeah, 2-on-1 break to Brooks.
That's a little physical there.
Goal with it. Fitzgerald's going to take the long three. Short. Pine with the rebound. Burris, that's back rim. Adams with it. Oh, he dribbled it off his foot, off his leg. Oh, no. He dribbled that off his leg. They're gonna keep it Millis ball. The inside ref had it right, but the outside ref called it off of Millis. All right, so we take a timeout. 3:46 left to go in the third, but Medfield's still well in control of this game, up by 15.
Yeah, you know, and the pace of it here in the second half, obviously Millis is trying to shake it up a little bit. More aggressive man. They're trying to fast break more when they get the opportunity. And it's definitely kept it a more balanced game.
They're trading baskets more right now than anything else.
But still shooting, 29% from the field.
Yeah, pretty bad.
Clean, only 2,000 Millis.
Yeah, very quiet second half so far from a foul standpoint. Okay, Doug's going to work the ball down. Some soft pressure by Millis.
Down roll.
Yeah, Fitzgerald with it. Comes all the way around the screen. The
nice
range of
take.
The drive.
Yeah, but that's a great move. That's the move.
There's a 3-on-1.
Oh,
it misses
nice job
the bunny.
Here.
Oh, Brooks with a nice move. Now they go back into the full court. And they didn't work it right.
Nice feed. Boy, I'll tell you, when you have a 6'6", 6'7" center who can make a pass like that, that's a nice weapon.
Yeah, but the problem there is they put the trap on before the ball even got inbounds, which left an open man.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
You got to wait to see where the trap's coming.
They're punishing them now. Man, that's when the press just can't work.
Exactly.
I mean, as a coach, that's your dreamland. You're hoping that... you can make it hurt badly.
Well, the other thing is, too, we've really seen a team that actually can put an effective full-court press on for the whole game.
True.
You know, very rarely will you see a team that with that high energy level and that fitness to do it.
You have to have 8 to 10 players to do it. Mm-hmm. You know, you've got to be willing to go deep in the bench and rotate them because you just can't do that for extended periods of time.
The teams that I've seen have done it. They kill you with it. I mean, they can wipe you out with it. But a very few teams either have the personnel or the bench strength to carry that out.
And without that, you just get a lot of tired players reaching. Because to do it, you've got to move your feet. You've got to be able to beat. On defense, you've got to beat the offensive player to the position, get there. You can't do the reaching. And when they're tired, you get that reaching, the matador defense as they're going by.
I remember back, now it's 10 years ago, when the Warriors went to the Garden against Watertown. Watertown put a full-court press on them the whole game that was chew them up.
Yeah.
And there was nothing to stop it.
Well, and the thing is, you haven't practiced really against it because no one does it, so.
It's relentless. But I think very few teams can do it. I don't think Millis is going to be able to do it. There's Burris with the turnaround. Oh, that's
a nice
move.
Play there.
He's got a few points. He must be their leading scorer.
He's at 10. He's tied with Andrew Brooks.
Okay.
A lot of touching, a lot of grabbing. Call a timeout.
Doug's with a double up. Does a nice job getting Fitzgerald.
You know, the play there is look for the shot. You got Mitchell underneath. He's going to be rebounding, so take the shot.
Here's Ellery with a Hillary with a long break. 14-point advantage. 8 seconds left to go in the third.
Really?
Stolen. Oh, and Millis with a quick 7-0 run.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's just
sloppy.
Very sloppy. You know, again, you know how to break a press, right? You know how to break a press. You just punished him doing it. Now you dribble into the corner and then try to.
Now this is a second game we've done this year. We saw this the first game that Metfield was well in control, but then kind of got into sloppy spells that you would say.
Yeah.
Kind of let the other team back in a little. Now it's still a 12-point advantage as we go into the fourth quarter. So Miller still has a long way to go, but. You know, they had to get it under our double digits to come into the fourth, but, you know, 12 still not a bad. They were down by 19.
Sure.
30 seconds ago.
Well, and Hilaire, you know, if you get someone all of a sudden who hits some threes.
Right.
You know, they were brutal, 1 for 11. Now, you know, only still 2 for 13. I'm not going to say this tidal wave is like, oh, my God, what are you going to do? But
we're sloppy.
Sloppy way to end it. You know, under a minute, you want to close them out. You don't want to do a quick 4-point give back. So.
All right. So, and it's going to be Millis ball. So, you know, that old Patriot double possession play is ineffective.
Yep.
Hillary with it. There's a long three-pointer by Wong. That's the first shot I think Wong hit all night. Oh, Mitchell almost walked there. Jump ball is going to stay Metfield way. Was that a 2 or 3?
That was a 3. It was a 3.
I don't think the scorekeeper knew what to put up there. It's a 9-point game, so it is under. Oh, that's
out of bounds. Yeah. They got to be ready for that double team.
That was a nice play by Letozic to come over the backside that way. All right, Mitchell's is coming out, and the Ranger back in. So Medfield's going to want some scoring touch back in the game. Thugs with it.
Sure.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a weird play. Lowe's going to get caught for the foul. That's a really weird play. Dumped that pot. He just took the ball and,
yeah, I don't know what he was trying
and dribbled
to
as hard as he could on the floor. Kind of created a jump ball.
Who's that felon?
Lowell, 23. Whoa, almost get thrown away. But just saved by Wong. Story back to Boris. Wong with the outside. With Tazak. Ooh, looks like he almost double dribbled there. Ball, dude.
And then look like he traveled. Well, they are like just a little allowing.
Boris is going to take the three. Back rim. There's a push shot.
Oh, come on!
Inside the Boris.
Jesus!
They walk. And Doug
just a meltdown here.
That's an unbelievable push shot. The Metfield coaching staff is up in arms.
They should be.
6:48 left to go. Yeah, all of a sudden,
when you see the player,
game,
like, you know,
separate himself.
Wow.
That was quite a push off by Hopkins. What's the Millis coach yelling about? Or did he give him a timeout before the travel? He might have. That was a break for Metfield.
Yeah, that's a big break.
That's a big break. Wow, they called a travel against Dubs, and I think they're going to give him the timeout. Really hard. How would they even know?
that's a tough one. But, you know, Millis now shooting after atrocious. They're shooting, you know, 37%, which when you're starting at 24%.
That's almost 50% to get to 37%.
Exactly.
let's see what they're going to do. Yeah, it's going to be midfield ball.
Yeah.
So we'll come back.
You can't do that.
Draws the judge.
That is a horrible call.
What do you think about that call, Jimmy?
Oh, you got to give him room. You can't set up like that. That is horrible. See,
there's a stamp. It's terrible.
They knew it. They was vindicated.
All right, so midfield showed a little life. That's a big basket. A big exchange right there. 6:25 left to go in the game. Warriors up by 9. Hopkins with it. Back to Hillary. Gonna try to drive against Fitzgerald. Suspends up, loose ball.
Oh, wow.
Looks like Hopkins.
Very liberal interpretation of this game going on.
Might have taken a step or two there. Hillary looking for it. Under 6 minutes. Potasak with a tough shot.
And that's not a foul, you gotta be kidding. Wow.
But you know what? Mayfield's just gotta get tougher.
Call a timeout. No, don't blow.
Wow. Almost. Nice. Boy, Mayfield just dribbled out of trouble there. Inside the range of that shot. The rebound by Boris. Whoa, it just gets rolled with nowhere.
Yeah, that's, thank you. Wow.
You know, look, I mean, Millis is pushing back now. Midfield's just got to step up and push back.
And honestly, they got to get some more players in the game. These folks are tired, yeah. You know.
Good base. Does, but it does play the whole second half.
Yeah, there's some diving going on here.
I mean, Millis is energized. Unbelievable as that might seem. They're kind of in the game. The range with a long three. That's a bad three.
Yeah.
Oh, another
thank you. Well, you know, it's funny. They charged it and he just panicked.
Hopkins had a clear lane.
Yeah.
He actually would have had a 2-on-1 if he just held on to the ball. His defender was running right by him.
Yeah. Well, there's a big chance here for a wide open basket. Yep, there it is. Horrible pass. You lead him, that's a layup.
But nice defense by Forrest. Nice recognition. Hillary with it. Pump fake up. Oh, nice pass to Letazak. The ball way up and in. 7-point game.
Oh.
4:50 left to go.
Wow.
Loose ball. Millis with it. He's got Hopkins on the wing. Oh, missed the bunny. Hillary with it. Oh, and banks it in. Is unbelievable.
Well, they're exhausted, and I'll tell you.
I think you're absolutely right.
You have to substitute at this point. You've got to get some other players in this game and trust your bench.
I think you're absolutely right. Good call. They haven't substituted. There's only been one substitution.
And, you know, and I would put Mitchell back in the game and have him, because they're getting a lot of easy layups. You park him in the middle like an aircraft carrier, you know. Well, you got to give Millis a hell of a lot of credit here. They have really taken it to the Warriors here in the second half.
I mean, they have no business being even close in this game. And I didn't think they were going to come close themselves. And,
but, you know, they've
really stepped up.
They've taken, you know, five more shots. So.
What, they've become much more active in the defense.
Much more.
They have ball hockey.
A lot of turnovers.
And Medfield has kind of gone into a shell.
Yeah. Well, again, and a perfect play there.
And Mitchell is
back
in the game.
They're clustered, and they don't.
But you're right, the other four have played the whole second half.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, well, Burris has come up big for Millis in the second half.
Yeah.
And there's a loose ball. Hillary just tracked
the right pass, but wrong throw. You know, it's just poor execution.
Okay, Burris with it on the left wing. Over to Adams. Back to Hillary. Kazak, top of the key. Going to try to drive. Shovel shot.
Give him some help. And you got it wide open
all the way
basket.
Around. There it is, Lowell. Up and oh, he doesn't get it dumped with it.
And
he
one.
Gets fouled.
Oh,
yeah!
That's a big one. That's a big one.
You got right. Big 3-point play here coming up.
Yeah, they needed that.
Dubs trying to extend the lead to 8. Back in, but gets it on rebound.
Take some time, settle it down.
Okay, I'm going 4 minutes. He got fouled. Adams. Okay. That was on the floor. So Medfield's going to inbound. Lowell behind his own, behind the Millis basket. Oh, Williams almost lost the dribble there.
Now roll.
Wrong shot. That's off.
It's not the shot you want.
No.
Not the shot you want.
Rebound by Burris. Done a really nice job in the second half.
Yeah, for sure.
Burris looking to move.
Well, someone else has to, instead of watching Mitchell, someone else has to be playing here, man.
I know. Hopkins with a nice move to save that. Hillary with it. And that is all. And Hillary gets the bounce. So he's come alive in the second half, too.
Hillary's been impressive.
5-point game.
There's got to be someone open.
That does a nice job getting to Fitzgerald. Low. Oh, he won. He had the shot, too.
Keep bringing in subs and we keep playing the same players, so.
Okay, this one looks like it might be coming down to the end. Okay, Hillary with it. Over to Letezak. Back to Adams, he's got a lane. Mitchell didn't shift over that
time.
Yeah,
and I don't understand. You got him in there for a reason. And
there's going to be a foul. That's going against Cushman. That's Millis' 15th foul. 3-point game. 2:42 left to go.
Oh. Wow, that's the danger zone. Are you kidding me? Dribble to the corner. Oh, my God.
Into a trap zone there. There's the trap zone right there. Oh, there's a, ooh.
There's a foul.
Fitzgerald swings
it. Take your time.
Over to Mitchell. Back to Williams.
Now roll. Go to the basket, Henry. Go to the basket.
5 on the shot clock. Inside Mitchell. Going to have to shoot. Dubs, long three-pointer. That's off. Rebound to Kazak. Millis.
Hilaire for them is feeling it, and I'll tell you, this is, you can just see the confidence.
Long three-pointer, oh my God! Letezak ties the game, this is unbelievable! 19-point advantage, a race, 1:48 left to go. On the wing is Williams,
he walks.
There's a timeout by Medfield, he walks.
Oh, he totally did.
This is incredible.
You know, at some point, and I know I keep saying this, you have to trust your bench.
Absolutely.
They needed to give these players
a blow here.
A blow. Yeah. Not in the last 3 minutes. Early in, you know, you're up by 19 in the third quarter.
You
give them a break.
You called it in the third quarter. And now you're in no man's land.
You can. You got to finish them out.
You got to ride with them. They're incredible. I mean, the way Millis was shooting,
Yeah, they are shooting now.
40%.
over 40%.
I mean, particularly Burris and Hillary have really come alive
in
the second half. Yeah. They're like changed players.
Yeah, I mean, Hillary, shooting 3 for 5, 2 for 3 from 2, 1 for 2 from 3 points.
And he's controlling he's doing the point guard duty.
Yeah,
He didn't play like that in the
No one did. And they could not have played more cold. So you go from 24% to over 40% in a quarter and a half. So.
And once again, Medfield's health defense has just slacked off.
Well, and this is tough, too, because now you're asking him, I'm not sure why you got your...
All right, there's a drive by Adams. Just bounces off. Who wants it? Oh, a nice rebound by Mitchell.
I can't believe they're not calling these fouls, though.
Williams to Dubs. Inside! But he's going to go to the line for 2 free throws. Now, the other problem is Medfield only has 2 team fouls. If they fall behind...
Yeah. No, you're absolutely right.
They're going to be in trouble.
Well, let's not fall behind. Let's put ahead by 2 right here.
Done.
That looked like a good stroke.
It sure did.
Well, you got 15 boxing Mitchell out, so... They got no one in the game right now. If he wants that ball, he's going to get it.
They're going to foul.
They're calling it on Mitchell.
Yeah, push off. They called the Beckle good.
Well, that'll help you on your foul count.
Actually, that was good.
Yeah, that's without any time off,
that's
you got
good.
Your foul. Good job, Henry.
Yeah.
That's good coaching.
I'd actually pick up another foul here, too, just in case.
So who, what is this?
All the way up and in, and that's off.
Look up, look up, you got people. Look up, you got... That's a ticky-tacky foul. Wow.
Sure was.
Wow. The stuff they haven't been calling and they called that? Oh, my.
That was...
I'm not arguing.
I thought he killed him.
He killed him there.
Wow.
Wow.
All right, still a 1-1, so he's still got to hit at least the front half of this. Makes the pick.
Big free throw there.
Yeah, this is a second 2-point game. 1:10 left to go. Miller's quickly up with it. Up back to Hillary. Oh, almost throws it away. Ooh, it almost double dribble. Burris with it back to Hillary.
Get up on him. Do not let him.
Long 3-point. Oh! Adams with the 3-pointer. And there's a lock. Oh, and it's the puck of the ceiling. Jimmy Miller's ball, 46 seconds
now left. We're in the foul situation. We're exactly what you said, Rich. Wow.
Warriors come up with a steal here.
They're up by 19.
And in cruise control. 17 points with 3 minutes left to go
in the third.
All right, that's good.
There.
Good foul. That's going against Lowell. That's good.
Yeah.
Do another one. Do two more. This goes good. That was a nice play that Mills ran up.
Yeah.
Let me tell you. Yeah, there you go.
There's your second. Okay.
Good job. They're doing exactly what they should do.
Yeah.
So one more, and now you'll erase that advantage.
There it is.
All right, there we go. All right, good play, good smart play by, good coaching by Medfield. The only thing you'd be worried about there
is...
if you get called for an intentional foul, you just got to be a little careful.
Yeah, no, those were all legit.
No, they were good. They were good. Yeah. Why'd he do that?
Well,
why'd he do that?
I don't know. I don't get that. Unless you got intelligence that this kid can't shoot free throws.
No.
I don't understand that.
No, coach
that.
Said, what are you doing? Okay. That was not the play.
No.
Okay, 1-1.
Brilliant. I mean, it's all coaching, you know?
That was not the play. Fitzgerald with it. 36 seconds left. Goes all the way up. Bruce Ball, who wants it? Got on the ground.
Oh, they gave him the timeout.
Wow. I don't even know if he had the ball.
Wow. 32 seconds left. Millis, unbelievable the sound, up by one. I can't believe I'm saying that.
Yeah, this is,
They swung this game by 20 points.
Well, and again, I know I'm hammering this, and I'm sure I'm gonna get a call from someone, but.
Yeah, from me. No, not
the bench. You gotta go deeper.
Right,
you gotta,
yeah.
And I keep hammering on it, but.
This is the trap. If you don't go deeper on the bench, you know, if a team makes a run at you like this, you kind of don't have the gas anymore to defend it off.
Yep.
And it did start to me. You kind of know where they got tied was on the team defense.
Yep.
That they weren't switching off and they weren't protecting.
Well, and then also, you know, a 4-6 point turn in less than 30 seconds on turnovers. You know, where they can't break the press. And they're just hoping to get out of the third quarter, and they give up 4 points in 30 seconds. So, again, you know, they've got 32 seconds here to
kind of pull
however
this
tired
one out
you
of,
are, absolutely. But
kind of pull this one out of the fryer.
And I'll tell you, Millis has kept this. This has been the crew they've had the last quarter. So once they found this group, you know, they're.
All right, so Fitzgerald with it. We're under 30. Williams with it, trickled it out. Differential
roll,
of about
roll,
11 seconds.
Roll to the basket. They're going to
the shoot
basket.
Here. Williams with it.
Roll
look at
to the
stop.
Basket.
Going to go up. Oh, that's a bad.
What the heck was play. That? What the heck was that? Behind the back?
I don't know. He got caught. It's going to be a foul. Ortega's going to go to the line. And he's hurt. He came down high. That was a crazy
behind
play.
Behind the back pass and well, come up, set a pick and roll.
Well, no, one of the problems is they ran out of shot clock.
No, I understand, but I'm saying even early in that.
No, I know, but the problem is they set up way too far. They needed to attack quicker.
Right, right.
Because they got caught.
Right.
And he got stuck in the middle.
But you're even better with Mitchell crashing the basket. Throw the ball up. Shoot it. You know,
yeah,
I mean. A behind the back blind pass into the middle of the lane.
He got caught in no man's land.
Should have shot.
Don't disagree, but now, right now, we got a 1-on-1. Millis up by one. 14.6 seconds left to go in this.
Wow, we thought this was going to be a laugh.
I did.
You know, we're.
Okay, Letezek's going to go to the line 1-on-1. This is obviously a huge free throw here.
And box out.
This is it. Rebound by Fitzgerald. We got 12 seconds left. This is it. This is all she wrote. Oh, a nice little stop to Mitchell. Back to Fitzgerald. 4 seconds. And it's off the rim. And it's off the rim. They're talking about it. Did the basket count or not?
I think so.
The foul, the basket count. With 1 second left to go on the clock.
Wow.
Jay Dobbs with an unbelievable clutch basket. Yeah. 1/10 of a second left.
That's incredible.
And there's a foul. And the And he goes to the line. They foul.
Okay.
Wow.
Incredible.
Wow.
I don't think we've ever seen a finish like that before.
Wow.
But it wasn't Dub. It was
Lowell.
That's going to be it.
A heartbreaker for them, and you know what? That's why you play the game.
Wow.
Let me go. I gotta adjust that. I had given it to Dubs, but that was Lowell.
Yeah, I think it was Lowell. It had to be Lowell, right?
Yeah.
I thought it was Dubs too, but it had to be Lowell.
Well, in case you didn't know, in midfield, cruised. Easy victory there. Just put the pedal to the metal and finished it. Gutsy performance there at the end by Lowell. I mean, that's a heck of a heads-up play to crash the basket.
Absolutely.
But let's quickly go through some stats here. John Lowell ends up with 10 points. Jack Fitzgerald, 10 points. Stephen Williams, 8 points. Dubs, 9 points. Steve LaRanger, 15 points. And that is the scoring. Millis really unloaded in the second half. Carter Burris ends up with 14 points. PJ Adams, 9. Latasek, 7. Raymond Hillary, whatever, 7. Andrew Brooks, 10 points. Nathan Wong, 3. Zanfrelli, who is one of their captains, only with 3 points.
Yeah, he didn't even play
really
in the second half.
So, hey, find a W. You know, coming off the Ashland game, you know, to me, this shows when they are rested and you've got to go deeper. You know, you're up 19. That's the time to unload the bench a little bit. And they're going to have to do it because that was a gutsy ending performance there, but a little bit too close for comfort.
Absolutely.
On a team they should have cruised.
Okay, Medfield moves to 8-4 and 8-2 in the TVL. So they're still in the hunt, which is also equally important. That loss would have really damaged their chances at a TVL championship.
Yep.
So, Jerry, it was interesting. Great game as it turned out to be. We didn't think that's going to start, but thanks. Thank you, Jerry. Eric Cazell, as always, great job. And this is Rich Small, and the score for the final time is Medfield Warriors 58, Millis Mohawks 57, and you are watching Medfield Big Blue Basketball on Medfield TV.
Medfield TV, community shows.